सिल्वर बॉक्स पर ही जानकारी होती। आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट द डिटेल्स अबाउट द आथर। द आथर वॉज बॉर्न इन 1867। ही वॉज डाइड इन 1933। ही वॉज ए नॉवलिस्ट एंड प्लेराइट एंड ही गॉट नोबल प्राइज इन लिटरेचर इन 1932। About the play, this play belongs to the 20th century, and this play has three acts. And the major theme in this play is social inequality between two classes of people. We know we have upper class and lower class people, rich people and poor people. This play totally talks about the class difference between rich and poor people. Then we can go into the characters. As I said, this play has rich and poor class people. There are characters from rich class people and the characters from poor class people. From rich class people, first I'm going to introduce the wealthy person called John Bardwick. He's a wealthy person. Next, his wife, Miss Bardwick. Next, his son, Jack Bardwick. Then from poor class, I'm going to introduce Miss Jones. Miss Jones is a charwoman who is working in John Bardwick's house. Then I am going to say the important character, that is Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones is a husband of Miss Jones. Next, we can see Jack Bardwick and Mr. Jones are the two important characters which we can see in the in this play. They are contrasting characters, and we can say what John Bardwick does in the play. It is not done by the Mr. Johns, and we are going to see the class difference between Jack and Mr. Jones. Jack is a rich man, and Jones belongs to poor class. So then there are a lot of characters. Then I am going to introduce the character called Snow. Snow is a policeman, detective policeman. Then there is a character called Roper. He is a solicitor for John Bardwick. He's a lawyer for John Bardwick. Then I'm going to say about the character called Jack Bardwick. About Jack Bardwick, I want to say that while reading the play, if we see Jack, we may we, when we read our we read Jack makes us laugh. Sometimes he makes us irritated, but we can have fun with Jack's dialogues and Jack's behaviors. So I have assumed Jack Bardwick with our comical character called Vadivelu. With Jack, we can assume in this seminar that Jack has Vadivelu. Then I'm going to start. I'm going to say what about Jack? Jack used to enjoy his life. He used to enjoy his life. He never cares about anything. He gets lot of money and he spends lot of money. He doesn't care about anything. He never cares about anything. He lavishly spends his money. Then we can start from the first act. First act begins with Jack. Jack, now he was drank the alcohol, and now we can see that he was in an unconscious state. He was in an unconscious state. So she enters before his house. There we can see he goes to the door, and in his hand he gets a key to open the door. But as he is in an unconscious state, he doesn't know where the hole is. So if we want to open the door, we may insert the key into the hole and we will open the door. But now Jack, as he is in an unconscious state, he doesn't know where the hole is. So he is searching for the hole. Now he is searching for the hole, and while he was searching for the hole, Jones enters, sir, and he helps Jack. He helps Jack to open the door. So after Jones has helped Jack was very happy, and as a sign of gratitude, Jack doesn't know what he's going to do for Jones. So he became sad because he doesn't have anything at the time. He gets spend everything in drinking. So when Jones helped Jack as sign of gratitude, he doesn't have anything to written back to Jones. So he says he doesn't have anything, and so that he says Jack invites Jones to his house. Jack invites Jones to his house. So Jones enters to Jack's house. So we can see a poor man, Jones, who enters to a rich man, rich man's house as a invitation, as a guest. He enters there. Then we can see they both started to drink alcohol. Then Jones he finds a silver box. It contains cigarettes. We can see cigarettes in the silver box. So silver box, and he also sees a purse which is in that room. Then he finds that a silver box belongs to Jack. Silver box belongs to Jack. Jack has cigarettes to smoke. Then he finds a purse, but this purse doesn't belong to Jack, because Jack, while he was in the drunken stage, he has stolen the purse from a lady. He has stolen a purse from the lady, and he has took it, and he took it to his home. The lady's name was not mentioned, so we can say her as an unknown lady. Then we can see Jones. Then he finds that Jack went to sleep. So after drinking, Jack went to sleep. So Jones finds that there is no one in the house. So Jones also in the drunken stage, he takes the silver box and purse with him to his house. So after that, after some time over, Jack wakes up and he doesn't know what had happened on the day when he was drunk. So now Jack sees that now he is waking from the sofa in the dining room. So every day Jack used to come to his home, and he used to sleep in his room. But now he has slept in his dining room in the sofa. So Jack, there he sees Miss Jones, who is cleaning the room. So now Miss Jones is there. He is cleaning the room. So Jack says to Miss Jones that he recuses Miss Jones that not to tell to his parents. Mr. Bartwick and Miss Bartwick not to tell to his parents. If Miss Jones tells to his parents, definitely they are going to blame, or they are going to scold Jack. So he asks Miss Jones to not to tell to their parents. So I can quote that Jack to Miss Jones: Don't you say you caught me asleep here? Please don't say you can't. You caught me slept in here. So Miss Jones also accepts that, and he doesn't reveal that to his parents. The next we can see Bartwick and Miss Bartwick, they are talking about the low class people. What they are talking about the low class people, Miss Bartwick especially says that low class people are selfish people. Low class people are selfish people, and they have no patriotism. Then we can see while they are talking, the unknown lady enters there. The unknown lady is whom Jack stole the purse from her. And we can say, after the lady enters, the lady says that he is searching for Jack, and she says to Mr. Bartwick that your son has stolen my purse, and he has taken to your home. In that way, she says to Mr. Bartwick. So at the time we can see Jack enters there. So Jack, while he enters there, he was shocked to see the lady, and he was confused that something I have did with the lady, but he could not remember what he had did with the lady. Somehow he committed the crime. He knows that somehow he committed the crime, but he doesn't know what crime he has committed. So the lady, while seeing Jack, he asked to return the purse. So while she asked, Jack is looking around for getting any chance to get away from the place. So but he could not get away from the place because Mr. Bardwick is noticing everything. So he says that I don't know anything about the missing purse. So in that way, Jack says. Then later, Jack remembers that he has stolen the purse. Then he goes into the house and he searches the purse, but he could not find it because the purse was stolen by Jones. This purse is stolen by Jones, which is not known by Jack because Jack was left at the moment. So Jack now he want to repay something to her. So he says that instead of a purse, he can give money. So he says that I can offer you a check. In that way, Jack says. So I can offer you a check. In that way, Jack says. But she denies to receive the check because she wants only the money, which is £7. In that purse, she has £7, and that £7 she wants because she need to pay her rent. So because she needs to pay her rent, so she wants the money only. So these are the things which are noticed by Mr. Bardwick. Bardwick then comes in the middle and he gives £8 to the lady, and the lady, after getting the money, she goes away from the house. Then we can see, after this problem has settled, Jack now he wants to smoke, so he asks cigarettes from Marlowe to bring. Marlowe is a servant working in Mr. Bardwick's house. So Jack asks cigarettes to Marlowe to bring. Now Marlowe says that he has searched for them silver box in the entire house, but he could not find that because cigarettes are in the silver box, and silver box was taken by Jones. We know that, but nobody knows that Jones has taken that silver box. So now Marlowe says that we can't find the silver box. So Marlowe says that the silver box is lost. So after hearing that, Jack and Marlowe, they are saying to Mr. Bardwick's, so the entire family members, they have a doubt in Miss Jones, because Miss Jones was working in the room where the silver box is kept. So on the day when the silver box is lost, Miss Jones was working in the room where the silver box is kept. So they are asking Miss Jones whether she has stolen the silver box. But Miss Jones refuses that she does not take the does not stole the silver box. So then Mr. Bardwick, he inquires about Miss Jones' life. He inquires about everything about her life. He inquires everything about her life. Then Miss Jones also says about her life. She says that she has three children. Then he talks about her husband Jones. Then he says that his husband is searching for a job because he has no job. Then he also feels that as he has no job, he could not afford any money to his children to buy. So as he has no job to buy food to his children, he feels so sad and depressed. Mr. Jones feels so sad and depressed because he doesn't have a job. As he doesn't have a job, he could not afford any money to buy food for their children. So he becomes very much depressed, and he used to drink. He used to consume alcohol, and then after consuming alcohol, he doesn't behave like himself. He behaves arrogant, and he always treats her wife badly. Then, but we can't say that Jones is a bad man, bad person. But we can say Jones is good. Is a good character because Jones is fond of children. He wants to do something for his children. He wants to do something for his wife, so that he is searching for a job, but he could not get the job. That is a thing. That is a sad thing happening in the poor's life. So Jones is very much depressed, and he so only he begins to drink. So then we can see. Then we can see, after hearing all these things about Miss Jones, Mr. Bardwick leaves her, and he sends her to her house. Then Miss Jones also leaves from Mr. Bardwick's house. Then we can see in Act 2. In Act 2, we can see Miss Jones enters to her house. After entering to her house, she finds that her husband was there. Her husband was there, and he was very much happy, and Miss Jones, she is inquiring about all the things from her husband, and in a certain period of time, Miss Jones finds that her husband has the silver box. Her husband has stolen the silver box. So now, so Miss Jones was very much shocked to see that her husband has stolen the silver box, because she refused that she has not stolen the silver box. But in her house, when she sees the silver box, she was very much shocked. So she was very much depressed, and she was blaming her husband. So while she was blaming and she was scolding her husband, we can see another character, Snow. Snow, a detective police officer, who enters into their house, and there he finds the silver box. The detective finds the silver box, which is in Miss Jones' house. So there he finds the silver box, and he catches Miss Jones, and he wants to arrest Miss Jones. So before arresting her, Snow asks to Jones that, "Do you wish to say anything before I take her?" He is asking, "Before I am arresting her, do you want to say anything?" In that way, he asking to Jones. So no, Jones, when he asked the question, he felt very much very, very shame, and he bends his head, because Jones does the mistake. Miss Jones. Doesn't do any mistake, but Jones does a mistake for committing crime by Jones. Miss Jones is being arrested. So this made Jones to feel shame, and he bends his head down. So, but he could not see that his wife Miss Jones is being arrested. So he comes forward, and he accepts the truth. He says that I have committed a mistake, I have stolen the silver box. In that way, he says. Then, but the detective Snow, he doesn't accept him, and he takes Miss Jones. He wants to arrest Miss Jones. So Jones, again he argues with Snow that he himself has stolen the silver box, and Snow should not arrest Miss Jones. So in that way, Jones argues with Snow. So the argument goes bigger, and so Snow arrested both of them to and he filed a case in stealing the silver box. Next, we can see the Act 3. Act 3 is trial scene. Actually, Act 3 is a trial scene. In that, we can see magistrate is there. he enquires about everything that had happened on the day. So he enquires with Miss Jones. Miss Jones refused that he has not stolen the silver box. In that way, Miss Jones says, and Mr. Jones also interferes, and he supports that Miss Jones does not do anything, and he says that he himself done everything, and he himself has stolen the silver box. In that way, he says. So we can see Miss Jones is released. Then Mr. Jones, he says that I have accepted my truth, and I need justice, that Jack also has committed the crime. Jack has stolen a purse from an unknown lady. In that way, he says. So Mr. Jones says Jack is to be punished. Likewise, Jones, Jack is also to be punished. In that way, he shouts to the magistrate. Then we can see about Jack, that while in the trial, he doesn't need to stand in front of the magistrate, but from sitting in the court trial, he is revealing what are the things that happened on the day. He is coming to reveal what are the things that happened on the day. He is trying to say that what are the things happened on the day. But Bathwick and his family members and the lawyers, they are trying to control Jack to escape or shut his mouth. So they are shutting his mouth. And we can see Jack, without his conscience, he is revealing all the truth. Then the verdict came, the final verdict came, the final judgment came. And judgment was favored to Jack. Jack was not punished, but Jones was punished. Jones was punished for stealing the box, stealing the silver box, and behaving harsh to the policeman. This was happened. Then I am going to say, give my own views about this play. About this play, I want to say that how the high class people, first point I am going to say, how the high class people, they are thinking about the poor class people. Then I am going to say how their views are wrong. I am going to prove that their views are wrong. They are thinking about the poor people in a wrong way. That I am going to say that. Then we can see the quotes, law grants the poor and rich men rule the law, by Oliver Goldsmith. And how this sentence was apt to this play, we are going to see. And we are going to see that rich men rule the law. How this is true. And we can see through money, how the rich men, they are writing the law, how they are ruling the law. We are going to see. So we can see money plays a major role in this play. Then we can have the solution which is given by the author. First thing I want to say is that how the rich people, they are thinking about the poor people, and how their views are wrong. First, we can start from poor people. They are thinking that poor people, they always used to say lie. They never tries to say the truth. In that way, they are thinking that. Miss Bathwick, she says that it goes all through the lower classes. You cannot tell when they are speaking the truth. You cannot tell when they are speaking the truth. But she is saying that we cannot find that when the poor class people are telling the truth and when they are telling the lie. We cannot find that. In that way, Miss Bathwick says. But the fact is, Jack from high class people, he is the only character we can, with this character, we can identify that he is the only man speaking, he is giving the answer in different times, giving different answers. One time he gives one answer, and another time he gives another answer, and another time he gives another answer. In this way, he is giving his answer. He is wearing with his answer. Now and then he is varying with his answer. So we can say that rich people are varying from their answers, and rich people are complaining the poor people that they are not telling the truth. They are we can't find the truth when they are telling the truth. In that way, rich people, they are accusing the poor people. But the fact is, rich people does that. Then we can see that when Jack drank on the day, he tries to hide that to the family. He says to Miss Jones not to tell to their parents, and till to the end of the play, from starting the play till to the end of the play, he tries to hide the truth. He tries to hide the truth. Then we can see Jack in Act 2, Scene 2, he says that I came in and went to the bed as usual. I came and went to the bed. He went to the bed as usual. But on the day, he slept in the dining room. He slept in the sofa. There he slept. I want to say that he came in, I went to the bed as usual. As usual, he used to go to room, but as he was drunk on the day, he has slept in the dining room. But he is saying that he went to the bed as usual. He was hiding to his parents, to his father Bartwick. Then in the same scene, we can see Jack's answer varies. Jack's answer varies. Jack tells to Roper. Roper is an advocate, judge. Roper is a lawyer, and he tells Jack tells to Roper that he slept on the sofa. On the sofa, there is I. She says like that. We can see first he said he went to bed. Next he reveals that he has slept on sofa. This in this way, his answers varies from place to place. Then we can see in Act 1, Scene 3, when the unknown lady claims her purse, Jack says that I don't know about anything. First he says I don't know about anything. Then later he says, well, then it must be here. Later he says that it might be in my house. In that way he says. Then later he says, It is his fault. It is Jack's fault. It is his fault. So he feels sorry for that. In that way he says. So his answer varies. His answer varies from place to place. So rich people, they are we can't find that when they are telling the truth, when they are telling the lie. We can't find that. In that way we can say that rich people's views are very wrong. Then we can see in Act 2, Scene 2. Miss Bartwick says that I hate people that cannot speak the truth. Miss Bartwick says that I hate people that cannot speak the truth. Those who are not able to speak the truth, she will hate the people, hate those people. In that way, Miss Bartwick says. But the fact is that Bartwick's family members, they are trying to hide the truth. They are not able to speak the truth. They are not able to speak the truth because when the court trial is going on, though Jack reveals the truth, they are shutting the mouth of Jack. When we can see when Jones is asking questions against Jack in the court that he has stolen the purse, Roper, the lawyer, he says to the magistrate that these questions are hardly to point. These are the questions. So he says that these are the questions are not important. That these are the questions are unwanted questions to be asked in this trial. In that way, Roper says, and he makes Jack to escape from the place. Then we can see how the rich people think about beggars. How the rich people think about the beggars. We can see first from Bartwick. Bartwick says that If any beggars come to him to ask any help, he will see their eyes. If it was straightforward, he will give sixpence to them. But if it is not straight to him, if it is not straight to him, if it is dull, then he will think that the beggars have drunk or they have committed a crime, so their face are being dull. But we can't say that we can say that beggars' face will always be dull. But Bhartik says that it should be in straightforward. Then only he will give sixpence. In that way he says. Then Miss Bhartik says that one day there was a poor man who came to Miss Bhartik and asked for help. I have had nothing to eat today. In that way, a poor man came to Miss Bhartik and he asked for help. So Miss Bhartik refused that because the poor man had dreadful eyes. So as he had a dreadful eyes, she thought that he might commit a murder. So in that way, she thought and she refused to help the poor man. Then we can see the law grins the poor and rich man rule the law by Oliver Goldsmith. Here the money plays a major role. We can see when Jack stole the purse, he escapes from the place. He escapes because by giving the money he settles the problem. Bartwick says that I shall settle this claim. Here is 8 pounds. The extra will cover the value of purse and your cab fares. In that way, Bartwick, his father gives money to the unknown lady to help his son to be escaped from the issue. So here we can see the justice is that Jack is to be arrested, but with the money Jack escapes. We can see when Jones reveals this to the magistrate about Jack that he has stolen the purse. Magistrate says I have nothing to do with what he or may have not taken. I have nothing to do. What I don't care that whether he has taken the purse or not. So this is the thing that money plays a major role. With the help of money, he escapes from the he is, as a loophole. He escapes from the place. So then we can see when, but we can see when Jones stole the purse, he was caught. He was fired, and he was filed a case. When he asked excuse, so Jones is asking excuse that I am a poor man, I have got no money. In that way, he asked excuse from the magistrate. But the magistrate says that all this won't help you. You must be quiet. You should be quiet. In that way, the magistrate replies, yes, that is true. If he is a poor man, this won't help him. Because if he had no money, that will not help him. In that way, he says. So if like Jack, he has the money. Jack has money. So but Jack has money. The justice is to be that Jack is to be arrested. But with the help of money, he escapes from the jail. Then we can see they are not noticing Jack's fault. So when Jack stole the purse from the unknown lady, they considered it as a not it as it that he has taken the purse. He has taken the purse. He did not stole the purse. In that way, he did not steal the purse. In that way, they are considering when Jack took the purse, they are considering he did not steal the purse, but he took the purse. In that way, they are considering. But we can see when Jones, sorry, this is Jones. When Jones steal the purse, he is considered as that he has taken the he has stole the purse and he has not taken the purse. In that way, he is voted. Then the magistrate replies we can see for this Jones argues that I have not stolen the purse, I have taken the purse. In that way, he argues, like as Jack, I have done, and he says that Jack has escaped, but I was caught. In that way, he says, but magistrate replies that you took it away from their house, and you took it to your house. In that way, he says. So, if we apply this same words to Jack, we can say that Jack took it away from the lady, and Jack took it to his house. So, you can see both Jones and Jack, they are committed a crime, but Jack was escaped, but Jones was caught. Then we can see, magistrate does not do. He tells that, I tell you that that is no excuse. So that there is no excuse. In that way, the magistrate says. So Jones is punished. So justice went to the side of money. Justice went to the side of money. So in the last, he says that whether this is a justice, whether you call this as a justice. What about him? What about Jack? What about Jack? He got drunk. He took the purse. It is money got him off justice. So money made him to come out of the law, and money gave him the justice. So in that way, Jones outs. So I'm going to say that with the solution that we can see that with money with the power, the rich people, they are escaping, they are writing the law, they are ruling the law, but the poor people, they suffers. So what is the solution? What is the solution which is given by the author? You can see author gives a solution as education. He wants everyone to be educated. He wants everyone to be educated. He says that if education comes to everyone, poor people, they will raise their questions. In that way, he says. So we can see in a scene, Miss Bardwick, she fears when the poor people are going to schools. So we can see Miss Bardwick says, exam is simply ruining the lower classes. Education is simply ruining the lower classes. Education is simply ruining the lower classes. It unsettles them, and that's the worst thing for us all, and this is the worst thing for us as represents to higher class people. So education is the worst thing for the high class peoples. So she says that I see an enormous difference in the manner of servants. So as their children, the servants who are working in Mr. Bathwick's house, their children are going to schools. You can see Miss Jones' children, three children, they are going to school. So we can see. So as they are going to school, as they are getting the education, Miss Bardwick finds the enormous difference in the manner of the servant. So Miss Bardwick fears that if education goes to everyone, definitely rich people can't rule the law, or they can't write their law. In that way, Miss Bardwick fears that. So this is the solution given by author, and I am going to finish this seminar. Thank you, and